Greetings people from Beers Blend and welcome back to bracket 2 of the 2017 Whiskey of the Year shootout. I haven't really thought about the precise title, but well, it's in the title, of course. Yes, bracket 2. Well, I am pretty stoked about today because, well, of course it's blind. And the first bracket really intrigued me a lot because you discover so much differences and familiarities between all of those whiskies. I do not know what's in these glasses. I do know which bottles are in the shootout. It are all the bottles that I reviewed this year, not including whiskies that I tasted off camera. All the whiskeys that I'm tasting, I have made videos about. And one whiskey will become whiskey of the year. Today we are, picking one out of these four whiskeys to proceed into the next bracket. And, if you want more info, check the first episode. But I suggest we get started. I also have these coasters on top. These are plastic whiskey coasters. They have, it was a gift. For my birthday, I just like this kind of whiskey memorabilia. If that's even proper English, I don't know. But this nice collecting like type stuff. That also contributes to my whiskey collection. I just like them. They have questions on them, and there's also a coaster with all the answers, etc. So it's nice. But the reason that I place these coasters on top is to keep the air in. Last time I noticed that there was a lot of aroma in the room, and well, I want to try to minimize that here today. I hope the light isn't too shiny in my glasses. I hope that it isn't too bothering for you, but it's nothing that I can, I can't do anything about it. All right, all the thingies are in place. They're all in order. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, let's go to the first one. Of course, I will try to identify them, just like I did in the first bracket. But glass number one, I suggest we get started. Yeah, I think I know this. It's definitely a sherry one, definitely. Right off the bat, there are some cask influences, a little bit of vanilla. It reminds me of Glenfiddich 18. But, I'm looking at my Speyside shelf. It can also be Macallan Sienna. Aberlour 12, I didn't review, but that's also stronger. To be fair, it can also be Glendronach 12-year-old. Well, the 12, 18-year-old. Definitely a sherry nose, no smokiness. Pleasant, complex. It has a nice color to it. It doesn't look colored, so I think I will be going with the Glendronach. But the Glendronach is really dark. This is lighter. But yeah, it can also be, of course, the lighting. But yeah, it doesn't have that fake haze to it. That fake glowy haze that a lot of colored whiskeys have. But it's a pleasant nose. I like it a lot. First off, I will nose every single glass. Then I will taste every single glass. And then, I will add 2 drops of water to each glass just to see what water does to the whiskey, if it enhances it or not. Glass number 2. This is a bit darker. Ooh, this is strong and nuttiness. I'm definitely getting nuttiness. It reminds me a little bit of some grass, some thick grass. There is also sherry in here. Maybe a hint of smokiness. This might actually be an older whiskey. The two are very similar, 1 and 2, but they are different. Different enough to well have them both, because well I have them, and that's really nice to see, because well people think whiskey is whiskey and it's just not. Even sherry whiskeys are really different, and these are both sherry whiskeys because I can just tell, and they are so different yet familiar and similar, and it's really interesting. That's what I love about whiskey. Nothing is the same. Well, except if you buy well, even batches can vary, but yeah, single barrel. I know, but let's stick to this. We're digressing a lot. Berries, cask. There is nuttiness. I think a little hazelnut with a hint of walnut, I think. Yeah. And of course the sherry notes. I'm not going too in-depth because, well, it's not review. Again, you can see on the screen which one I am having. And, well, if you want to know more, then, well, I will leave, of course, links in the description to all the, separate reviews. And you can check that if you want to, of course. Third glass. I also poured, I let myself pour just at a hint. Minder. Well, that's my Dutch for you. A little bit less. This is more mellow. More vanilla, more honey. It smells of good age, though. It's not young. To be fair, in my whiskies, I can't smell any youngness. Because, well, I do research before I buy my whiskies. And... well, I actually have a whiskey. Where you can really sense the youngness, etc. So, I buy all my whiskeys away, as far away as possible from that youthness note. Yeah, there is maybe a hint of sherry in this. But the bourbon and American oak casks are definitely dominant. I do not think this one has European oak on the nose. European oak is more fuller, more deep, dark, bitter, more intense. This is more smooth, if you know what I mean. Not that demanding. Yet very complex. I like it a lot. That's a nice pleasant nose, if you don't want a really intriguing whiskies. The first two were intriguing, that one is a nice break from that. That's why I do this. These are really, really interesting. The fourth and the last one. Ooh! Ooh! This one has a hint of... kind of the paint thinner that I remember from Jack Daniels. But this isn't Jack, because, well, I did not include it. It's fading away, though. But it's not as strong as in the Jack. Because the Jack Daniels are like that paint thinner note. But this is really... It reminds me of that, but it's not the same as you get in a Jack Daniels, of course. But this is... fruits? A hint of banana, maybe? This might actually be the Westland American Oak, now I think about it. Because there's only one whiskey which has a really intriguing banana-type nose that I have opened at the moment, which is Westland American Oak. So this might be Westland American Oak. It's complex, it's smooth, it's nice. I like this a lot. And, well, it has that natural kind of color to it, what I can see from the glass. Some fresh fruits. No sherry, I think. Pleasant, though. Pleasant, really pleasant. Bourbon vanilla notes. Ooh, I like that one a lot, though. All right, so we have, as far as I know, two sherry whiskeys here. And two less or non-sherry whiskeys. So that's interesting. I do not know from the top of my head which whiskeys I reviewed, which one I did not review. Don't think that I know every single video that I made out of the top of my head, because I do not. I can, of course, look at all my whiskeys that I have on my shelves here. But to be fair, a couple that I did review, I haven't tasted in months. So, yeah. I suggest we try the first one. Nice. I think I know what this is. Right off the bat. Wow, I can't even speak. Right from the start, it has that intense chocolate, vanilla, bourbon, sherry note. Which reminds me of my Macallan Sienna. And I absolutely... I can't even speak. There we go. I love my Macallan Sienna for that intensity, richness, sherry. It's definitely a sherry one. And I did not review, a whole bunch of sherry whiskies. And I remember my Macallan Sienna very well because it's one of my favorite. On the nose, it is not that familiar to my Macallan Sienna though. I'm getting a little bit of sweetness, gum sweetness, in combination with the nose and the taste, and well, the taste is really pleasant. It has that intensiveness. So I think number one is the Macallan Sienna. Am I right? Am I wrong? I don't know. Let's cleanse the palate. I have my water. There is no bubbles in here. That's just the seal that that you just heard. Alrighty then. I will put it right there. Huh. Nice. There are more expensive and cheaper whiskies in this entire shootout, by the way. So that's also why I'm doing this. You don't need to pay a whole lot to get a quality whiskey. It's just there are certain rules to it. 20 euros or cheaper... 30 euros or cheaper, well, between 20 and 30, you are not going to find anything life-changing. If you get into whiskey, it's a good place to start. But if you're an advanced whiskey drinker, you have had a lot of whiskeys, you stay away from that place. In my opinion, the best whiskeys are between 25 and 50, maybe 75. That's the place where you find the best bang for your buck, if you want to say it. There are, of course, between... I do not have any bottles above 100. At least that I paid more than 100 for. So, yeah, that's kind of my margin, unless it's really something special. But for me, the sweet spot is most of the time between around 30, 40 to, well, maximum 100. That's what I spent on my whiskeys. I apologize. Second one. This one is much more earthier and barrel influence, and I don't know, berries. On the nose, I prefer the first one because the sharpness of berries in the nose, it's not pleasant. I have noticed that, well, berries and the sharpness of them. If you might experience something similar, mellows down if you let it breathe for a second, the whiskey in the glass. So, or maybe with some water. So, yeah. Coming from that Macallan Sienna, this one is much more calmer. Yet complex, and in the aftertaste and the finish, it comes alive a little bit. There's the intensiveness, cask influence, yeah, definitely. This is also not a bad one. It has some really nice characteristics to it. I like this. But I think I will just go with the Macallan Sienna between these two. If I had to pick now. So that's kind of a thing. Yeah, the berries have mellowed down. So, yeah. But yeah, I'm keeping these coasters on them just so that I can experience everything in the full, you know? Normally, I won't do this. Unless, well, I'm sipping on a whiskey for a very long time. So, yeah. Because you can take your time with a glass of whiskey. You can take about an hour, maybe 2 hours, just with one glass of whiskey. But yeah, then I advise indeed using one of these just to keep the vapors inside so that the nose doesn't die down, you know? All right, well, let's cleanse and let's talk about something. I advise you to do the same that I'm doing here. Keep in mind, you need to, well, categorize your whiskeys a little bit. Do not include bourbons with single malts or scotches. Keep high ABVs away from low ABVs. And, do not include really heavy, peaty, smoky whiskies with some delicate and light whiskies. If you have more peaty whiskies, then I advise just keeping them together in a bracket or something. And just, take those more elegant whiskies. Speyside, maybe even Lowlands, Highlands, maybe Island, not Isla, Island, there's a difference. Islands are just islands around Scotland, for instance, Highland Park is an island, Jura is an island, but Isla is the Isle of Isla. And, you can look it up, but those are the regions. So, yeah, do as I say. Then you should be all good with your blind tastings. And if you want any advice, you can, of course, always ask me, no problem. Now, well, I think we're good. Number 3. It's so different, yet nice in a similar way. Ooh. Intense development and finish. I thought I was getting some smoke. Not sure though. But yeah, smoke can often be associated, of light smoke I should say, can often be associated with casks, older whiskies, that type of stuff. Maybe this is a sherry whiskey after all. It has a light nose, yet the taste is different coming from the development and the finish. Pleasant though, I like it. This is hard. But I think I like number 3 above number 2 at this point. And I have an idea which one number 2 is. I think that one is Glenfiddich 18. No, I did. Did I review Glenfiddich 18? No, I did not review Glenfiddich 18. That's what I'm saying. I'm keeping this all mixed up. Because I did review some whiskies, but they didn't, find their way to YouTube. Because, well, I was short of time. I didn't like the way I reviewed them. But yeah, then in my head, I have reviewed them, but you haven't seen it. You know what I mean? That's the same with Abelauer 12. I thought I reviewed it, so I all included it on the list. And then I was like, because I checked my memory and the YouTube timeline of my channel. And I was like, hey, where is it? And well, I didn't review it, so it had to go off the list, of course. Huh. Number 3 is very interesting. It's delicate, light. Well, I don't want to say light. It's delicate and complex. Instead of harsh and, like, demanding, like an Isla or something. It's not a Lowland, because I do not have any Lowland whiskies. Because, well, the only Lowland distillery that is kind of, well, a thing, I should say, is Okotoshin. Which means corner of the valley, by the way. So, yeah. Other than that, well, you have Glenkinchie, but just... I have to be in the mood for delicates. really delicate whiskies, because Lowlands are really, really delicate. Nice nose. It's not... Well, there isn't much going on in the nose. I should actually... clean the nose out a bit. It's important, you know? Yeah, it's definitely different from one and two. I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself. But 3 and 4 are similar. In certain ways, like bourbon characteristics, that kind of stuff. American oak casks, bourbon casks. I know Balvenie Doublewood is somewhere in the shootout. I don't know where. I haven't tasted it in months. How full is that bottle actually? Not above the label, but... Huh. I think Balvenie Doublewood is somewhere in here. Three or four. These two are definitely sherry heavy, 1 and 2. 3 and 4 are more of a combination, if you know what I mean. I'm not gonna look at my shelves and, well, guess or stripe away or... Yeah, I'm not gonna do that stuff, but... It reminded me of a combination and, well, Doublewood, Balvenie Doublewood popped into my head, because that is a combination of sherry casks and bourbon casks, if I remember correctly. Doublewood, yes. There's a nice nose, though. I am getting sherry in here. In the aftertaste. And in the nose. Huh. I like number 4. It's delicate, yet rich of scents and complexity, and it's so nice. In the taste, it's smooth, and then in the finish, it starts to come alive a little bit, tingles a little bit, lingers, mouth waters like crazy, chocolate appearing. Wow. Huh. This is an easy drinking whiskey. This is a dangerous whiskey. You can just sip this for hours. And before you know it, the whole bottle is gone and you're drunk and we don't want that to happen, now do we? So, well, yeah. I think I am doing this for the moment. 1 and 4 I like a lot. 2 and 3 aren't bad. They're good. If I would say anything, it's hard to choose between 3 and 4. But I think number 3, well, it depends on the mood, really. Yeah. Between these two, it depends what you want. Do you want a sherry whiskey? Well, then go with this one. Do you want a more... bourbon characteristic whiskey with more bourbon notes, vanilla, honey, etc. Then you go with number 4. So, yeah, which one do I like? Well, it depends on my mood. I'm not in the mood for anything, really. If I'm in the mood for anything, I'm in the mood for smoke. And that's not in here. So, yeah, I can choose between these two. They're both equally good, I would say. And, well, it's pointless to choose because, well... Now it's all about these two. I am going to add water to all of them. Let's do that now, in fact. First to the first one. I think I might add just a small drop, though, because I have less whiskey in here. Yeah, that's not gonna work, is it? No, it is not. Remember, by the way, to keep notes of the amount of water you add to your whiskeys. Because some whiskeys take a lot of water, some do not. And well, those points of remembrance, those memory points, like, oh yeah, this whiskey takes a half teaspoon. By the way, I suggest you use a teaspoon. You can get these fancy drop thingies, but if you are somewhere in a bar or something, or in a friend's house, well, everybody has a teaspoon in their house. And it's just a good measuring device, so that you always have the same amount of whiskey and water. So yeah, I'm just gonna add one drop, because well, I do not have that much left, because last time I did have a lot of whiskey, so it was a kind of a big drop actually. But yeah, if I am correct and this is Macallan Sienna, then well, it should enhance the intensiveness, but it should die down in the rest of the notes. Oh wow, this actually got really chocolatey. Interesting. Hmm. Yeah, I think this is definitely Macallan Sienna. I remember Macallan Sienna becoming really chocolatey, and there's the intensiveness. But this is a delicate whiskey. This Macallan Sienna, if I am correct, at least this one does not take water very well. The finish, etc., the aftertaste, the development to the aftertaste and the finish are nicer, different. But well, in the beginning, it just tastes a little bit watered down. So, yeah. This one I definitely prefer neat. But I can see why somebody would add a drop to this. Maybe not straight away, just sip some neat. I always suggest, just sip your whiskey neat a little bit and then start experimenting with water. Don't add water immediately. You want to take the journey, you know? And I can see myself just drinking a glass of neat Macallan Sienna and then maybe have a glass with a little bit of water. Because the aftertaste and the nose are really different and nice and chocolatey and rich and yeah. It depends. And that's the whole thing with whiskey. It depends. Tastes and smells are personal. So don't take anything for granted that I say here. I try to, well, review my stuff as objectively as possible. But of course you are personally influenced with what you like and what you don't like. Because, for instance, I don't like the sharp fruitiness, the sharp berryness, fresh fruits, that kind of stuff, the sharp fresh fruits. The full rich fresh fruits like juice oranges, red apple, I like. But like the fresh pear and the fresh berries, not that a fan. So, okay. Watch me being completely wrong here. That this is not Macallan Sienna. It's in fact, I don't know, Cardhu 12-year-old. Because I did review that, I believe. Yes, I did. And that dog next door, I am definitely gonna kill someday. I am so annoyed by it. Oh my god. I do not hate dogs. I just hate that one. Okay. Let's go to... Well, yeah. Let's just add water to all of them. Why don't we... One small droplet. The alcohol is getting to me. Nah. Yeah, I can see letting this sit for a bit, getting some air into it. I would like this a lot more, but yeah, it's definitely more on the sharp berry fresh fruit notes in the beginning. But yeah, already now it's mellowing down a bit, and I'm getting some nice wood notes and cherry notes and chocolate notes in here now. Some barley notes, yes. Maltiness also, yes. Oranges, maybe. But then some juice oranges. I don't want to say bitter, but there's not that fresh, fruity, like orange fruit fresh note, sweet note. You know what I mean? It's oily. It has a nice finish, nice punch. Huh. Interesting. That one is nice with some water, actually. I like it. Yes. I quite like it a lot. Well, that one, yeah. Then two, of course. Just gonna check 3 and 4 here. I think what my winner is, though. These are all nice whiskeys, just in the first bracket. Because, well, I bought all of them. And I would not buy a whiskey that I don't like. So, yes, of course, I like all of them. So there is not a loser here. But, yeah, which one is the winner? Yeah, that's not working. Get in the glass, you stupid. There we go. Well, what do we have here? Number 3, just gonna check real quick. Yeah, of course, nice. Maltiness. Casks. Indeed, maybe a hint of sherry. Maybe, far, far away. But that may be because, well, I have some sherry whiskeys here. Between the rest, so let's do a little cleansing. Yeah, the cleansing definitely helped a bit to bring out the more subtle notes in this one. Oh, wee! That taste, that palate has improved with maybe the time in the glass or with the drop of water, or it has become rich, active, full. Nice. I used to say, well, I don't experiment with water and whiskey, blah, 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 blah. But now that I am, I'm really experiencing the difference that it makes. I personally don't do this myself, but well, sometimes you can maybe pour 2 glasses with 1 whiskey and well, 1 neat and 1 with just a bit of water. 1 drop, 2 drops, and then take it up where, well, you're like, well, I like it here. Or to the point, well, I don't like it. This is better, you know? But whatever works for you. And then you can really notice the differences. Of course, you can also start with neat, then add some water as you go. But for comparison, you can go between them. But yeah, number 3 is ahead of number 2 at the moment. Number 3 has changed a lot. And I like it a lot now. It's definitely back in the race. The aftertaste. Some whiskeys have this malty aftertaste. This one doesn't. This one has a nice vanilla, cream, caramel. I like number 3. Number 2, yeah, that's definitely falling a little bit short here. It may be because if I no, it cannot be Glenfiddich 18. What is in here? For the life of me, it reminds me of Glenfiddich 18. What else did I review? Cardhu. Well, Cardhu has some apple hints, so that's not it. What can it be? What can it be? What can it be? I do not know. What are you? I don't know. Well, final glass. How long are we proceeding? 35 minutes. My God, this is a long one. Well, I am quite enjoying myself. Are you? Oh, this is way too much. Oh, I'm drowning it. Oh my God, no. I'm getting some citrus. Lemon. Maybe some fresh grass. Some shrubbery for some reason. This one is transforming. Yeah, I think this is the Westland American Oak. I am not sure though. I'm not sure if this is the Westland American Oak. But if I had to guess, because, well, I have on my shelves whiskies that I did review, between whiskies I did not review, so yeah. This can be Westland American Oak. Yeah, it can be. This is Westland American Oak. It has that subtlety, you know? That quality feel. Yeah, I remember the aftertaste. To be fair, the aftertaste and the finish are quite similar to number three there. But this is quality. Yeah. I think this is the Westland American Oak. It's subtle, yet so rich and complex. I have to hurry up. I'm all out of number four. I'm getting some reminds of Nutella for some reason. There's some nuttiness in the middle of it. Oh, I don't even want to cleanse it. I can just crawl up in a ball right to or in bed, or just at the couch watching a movie or a TV show with this beside me, and I'll be the happiest person alive. If I am right, and that is Westland American Oak, because for the life of me I cannot guess what else it is. There are non-smokies in here. These ones are not smoky, that's what I'm trying to say. Oh yes, they are pleasant. Yeah. Number four definitely has that sense of quality to me. Yeah. If somebody says you cannot taste quality in whiskey, well, if I am right and this is a Westland American Oak, then yes, you can taste quality in a whiskey, even if it is a non-age statement one. It's all about the quality. That's it. The quality. Quality products produce a quality whiskey. That's the end. All right. I'm not going to check number two again. No. Between number two and number four wins. So number two is out. Between number three and the rest. That's so nice. I'm just going to shoot him here. Just going to... Yeah, with water, this one is better, but if I am right, and this is the Macallan Siena, because of the whole watered down texture, I remember. God damn it, this is close. These are all equally good. For the life of me, I cannot... This one is more chocolatey. This one is more sherry. They are both intense, rich. I think I'm going with number three. That one goes so well with water. So well. But these two are so good. But yeah, I think number four is the winner. because it's just 1 or 2 or 3% more subtle and complexer. Yeah. These ones are more upfront, like, here I am, here I stand, this is my name, how are you? This one's more like a really interesting person, but a little bit shy. Know where I'm going with this? Yeah. Okay. Just a little bit. They are similar, but different. But yeah, I think number 4 is the winner. Choosing between these two would absolutely kill me. But if I have to, they are both shared, I think. If not, then not. I think this one stretches out a little bit further. Yeah, so the winner is number 4 here. Coming in behind that close. Like 10%, 20%, no, not 20. Between 10 and 50%. Less, in my opinion. Number 3 coming in. Cannot waste a single drop. And then at like a 5% difference, number 1 comes in. This was a close one. It took some time. But it was worth it. And this has probably, this one was more interesting than the first one. I am even more curious to find out what was in these glasses. I can guess, but of course you don't know for sure. And what is in number 2? Two, I cannot for the life of me say what's in there. Number 1, I say McKellen Sienna. Number 2, maybe Highland Park Herald. Well, Highland Park Herald is smoky. Yes, I know, but I can remember it being subtle, neat. I have never tried Highland Park Herald with water. So, yes, and the neatness of number 3 kind of reminds me of Highland Park Herald, but I think the smoke of Highland Park Herald has died down. Highland Park isn't very smoky to begin with. I can remember which one reminded me with a little smoke, but I think it's just number 3 and the smoke has just mellowed down a bit. If it is not Highland Park Herald, what would I guess then? Maybe Balvenie Doublewood. Quite a price difference. But, yeah. Huh. Dalmore 15 is also somewhere in here. I think 2 might be Isle of Jura. This one. This might be Isle of Jura. I'm not sure. But this one, well, it can be Highland Park Herald. I haven't tasted it in quite a while, so maybe it is still smoky, maybe it isn't. My Lagavulin has died down in smoke quite a bit, so that's why I'm saying it. If it is not Highland Park Herald, what would I, well, say? Well, then maybe indeed Dalmore. And then this one is probably a Westland American Oak. Probably. Anyway, I thank you for watching. I think I have, taken enough of your time already. Leave a like. A couple days, we shall continue with bracket number 3. So, yes, I am quite, intrigued to find out what else is in here. But, close one. Definitely. Especially between these two. Yeah, number 1 and number 3 here. These two are really close. This one is just a leap, a small leap in front. But I can go with these any day of the week. They are really pleasant. This one goes really well with water. Really, really well. This one doesn't, and this one, goes well as well. Thank you for watching, and now I say, of course, goodbye. Still a nice one.